often when we ask companies to describe themselves, because we've got a function of introducing companies to potential Chinese partners, and we ask them to describe themselves. And more often than not, companies here will describe themselves as, we are a quality manufacturer of XYZ, or we are a quality supplier of XYZ, and we've been doing it for the last 30 years, and some big companies will say, oh, we are a heritage company, family owned for blah, blah, blah. And that's, for us, it's okay. In China, it's fairly meaningless and potentially dangerous. Because just by throwing out, oh, we're quality, without backing it up by what are the elements of your company which in combination justify the statement that you are quality, then it's too simplistic. And if it's too simplistic, there are elements which raise doubt. Doubt leads to mistrust, and mistrust means you're not going to get very far in any form of business relationship. So there's a lot more work to be done by yourselves in explaining who you are as an organization, what is the service you're offering, what is the product you're offering, and what is it about the makeup of your company in these sort of areas which in combination justify your statement as saying we are quality. Once you've done that and you've actually started to you've got your presentation material appropriate for China, you have to start thinking about intelligence. And I'm not saying no anyone in this room isn't intelligent. I'm in terms of intellect. I'm talking about in terms of how they make an approach and how they view the Chinese market. So there are elements of quality which lead into intelligent design, experience, staff, etc., etc. And these make up your intelligent approach, how you're preparing to present yourself in the market and who you're looking to talk to be a suitable match. The next part is the intelligent understanding. How does your market work in China? What are the regulations? How do most people go into the market? Is it by themselves? Is it through joint venture? Is it through e-commerce? And how do those systems actually operate? What do you need to know to actually enable those systems as well? This is what we refer to as intelligent understanding. Do most companies do this? Unfortunately, I would say not. Most companies meet a Chinese partner who says, I love you, I think you're wonderful, I love this product, let's all make lots of money together. By the way, you have to invest into my company for us to do this, da 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 da. And that's the wrong way of approaching things. You have to have your own understanding of what is likely to work for you and be strong in following your own path. The final point, and this is the one where unfortunately I think no one with, even if you live for 10 generations, I think most people are going to struggle with in China. It's the intelligent negotiation. Chinese people are exceptionally good at negotiation, and we're not quite as good, let's put it that way, as the Chinese are. But on this, it's an interesting point, is we often hear this criticism of China, is that the Chinese, they always like to come back to negotiate. Well, from a Chinese perspective, is that because they're doing it because they're being wanting to be particularly annoying? No, they're doing it because actually negotiation is a part of life. It's something which you do with your friends and family all day. You do it with your neighbors, you do it with the local shopkeeper, you do it in big business. And for them, the number of times I've heard Chinese friends doing business within China saying, ah, I know I shouldn't have gone into that deal. I know in a month's time I'll regret it. Who do they blame? Do they blame the person they negotiate, or do they blame themselves? They blame themselves. But do they feel really bad about it? No, because they know next month, when there's another order to discuss, they have that opportunity to try and be a little bit better and negotiate better for themselves. So it's a continuous game of negotiation which goes on in China, and it's a sort of like a personal struggle between two people. Is it personable? Is it personal? Is it an affront to you as a person? No. It's more of a challenge and something to be enjoyed. And Chinese people really enjoy the challenge. We don't to the same extent. And so that's why negotiation in China can be quite difficult. How you can prepare yourself for the negotiation is through your intelligent approach and your intelligent understanding of what you should expect in the market.